Ayan na siya. Ayan. Ito ay pa safe. Pwede tayo mabasa.
Ayan, isang pala ang green na yun. Pero ito, ayun, Niagara din yun.
Thousands of years ago, the falls was 11 kilometers downriver from its current location. Erosion was a major issue associated with Canadian falls. The average rate of erosion at Niagara Falls was as much as 1 meter per year until the early 1950s. Since then, the water diversion channels and canals used for generating electricity have decreased the water. The decks will become wet and slippery. When moving about the vessel, please watch your step and hold on to the handrail, especially when going up or downstairs.
Here's the line green anyway. Pero ito, ayun, Niagara din yan. Hornblower.
As we make our way up the Niagara River, look to it can best be described as being near the left of the Horseshoe Falls and is located between Prospect Point and Loon Island. According to scientific study and historical research, it has been concluded that the American Falls will eventually be directed by
a
for your safety, thank you for choosing Hornblower Niagara Cruises. High flow rate of water causes the fall of large sections of bedrock from the American Falls, which is composed of soft shale and limestone. Though the height of the American Falls is higher than the Canadian counterpart, as we make our way up the Niagara River, look out, it is located on the left side, just to the right of the American Falls, separated by Loon Island. Loon Island is much larger and separates the American Niagara Falls from the Canadian Ocean Falls. The height of Niagara Falls is 181 feet or 55 meters, and remains the smallest waterfall compared to its two counterparts. Reducing the erosion of Niagara Falls, and to this day, Niagara Falls remains a clean and significant source of hydroelectric power. There are over 500 waterfalls in the world taller, but Niagara Falls is the biggest waterfall in the world by volume of water flow at an average of 750,000 gallons per second. Niagara Falls' interesting facts include The white foam floating on the water is dissolved limestone and is created naturally due to the massive erosion forces of falling water. The height of the Canadian Falls is 107 feet or 52 meters. The estimated crestline, 2,200 feet or 670 meters wide. Inches of erosion. The high flow rate of water causes the fall of large sections of bedrock from the American Falls, which is composed of soft shale and limestone. Though the height of the American Falls is higher than the Canadian counterpart, no air devil will overflow 75,000 gallons or 8,800 liters per second. In a recent Hornblower rock fall, in 1954, a large section broke off and fell near the end of prospect. Next is Brian of Red Falls. The snow was coming in 3 miles long. There was no feeling in the air. In all its natural beauty, continues to be a holiday spot for millions of visitors each year. Geological studies and the history of Niagara Falls indicate that thousands of years ago, the falls was 11 kilometers downriver from its current location. Erosion was a major issue associated with Canadian Falls. The average rate of erosion at Niagara Falls was much as 1 meter per year until the early 1950s. Since then, the water diversion channels and canals used for generating electricity have decreased the water flow, reducing the erosion of Niagara Falls, and to this day, Niagara Falls remains a clean and significant source of hydroelectric power. There are over 500 waterfalls in the world total, but Niagara Falls is the biggest waterfall in the world by volume of water flow,
and
an average of 750,000 gallons per second. Niagara Falls' interesting facts include the white foam floating on the water. Niagara Falls, more specifically, is the name of three waterfalls. Next is the awesome natural beauty.
Ha ha ha!
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us today aboard Niagara. We sincerely hope that you enjoyed your voyage to the falls. As we approach the dock, please do not move about the vessel and refrain from using the stairs until the vessel is secure. Once alongside the dock, our crew will direct you to either the forward or rear gangway for disembarking. Check to make sure that you have all your belongings and proceed to exit the vessel. Visit our mist gear shop for those last minute items, or join us dockside at Hornblower's Riverside Patio Bar and Grill and enjoy Niagara wines, craft beer, and a selection of delicious entrees, snacks, and foods. On behalf of captain and crew, thank you for sailing with Hornblower Niagara Cruises.
Thank you. Say bye.
Bye-bye.